The Republican-controlled Florida legislature is currently working out their details for their school budgets for the coming year. And as part of their punishment of the 12 school districts that defied Ron DeSantis and put mask mandates in place to protect their children, they're going to be starving those schools of roughly $200 million of our Florida taxpayer money. They're taking it away from those schools and giving it to the 55 other school districts in the state that blindly followed the stupid advice of our idiot governor. And of course, left kids vulnerable to COVID. 12 school districts are being punished. Now, don't worry too much, right? Because the Republicans, who again control our state legislature, they've already come out and they said, listen, everybody's budget for this coming year is going to increase, including those 12 school districts. What we're doing is just increasing theirs less because that's their punishment. So even though it's school districts in the largest districts here in the state of Florida, I mean, listen to this. Alachua, Brevard, Broward, Duval, Hillsborough, Indian River, Leon, Miami-Dade, Orange, Palm Beach, Sarasota, and Volusia. If you're not familiar with Florida, those are the places you've heard about, right? If you've ever traveled to Florida, like on a vacation, those are probably the places that you went without even realizing it. And a lot of them do suffer from extreme poverty. So the additional boost in school funding would be wonderful. I know Leon County specifically, you know, over there with Tallahassee, the state capital, they desperately needed that extra money. And of course, they're being robbed of it by the Republican, you know, right-wing authoritarians that run the state of Florida now. And the worst part about all of this is the only people who suffer from this are the teachers and the students. Like, that's it. The teachers and the students will suffer from not having this additional funding. Because again, all they wanted to do was protect themselves and protect the kids. Nobody got hurt. Nobody passed out from carbon dioxide poisoning, as Republicans tell us. And of course, predictably, these schools actually saw lower cases than schools that did not have mask mandates in place. So the masks worked. And I think that's probably what pisses off Ron DeSantis more than anything. That these schools were right, he was wrong, so he is using his political power to rob them of money, which is going to starve these children of proper educations. And of course, it's all going to fall back onto the teachers. If you do not personally know anyone in the education field, anybody who is a K-12 educator, let me go ahead and fill you in on things, because I know a lot of them, plus I'm married to one. I spend a couple $100 every single month buying supplies, not just for my wife's classroom, but for her school. I do what I can to help out the other teachers as well. And of course, they do the same thing. And I'm buying 4 or 5 boxes of copy paper for that school every single month. Paper towels, pens, pencils, all kinds of things. We don't get reimbursed for that because, by the way, thanks to the 2017 Republican tax cuts, they actually reduced the amount of money that teachers can write off for what they spend on their classroom. So that money's just gone. And we're talking about people who bring home less than $3,000 per month here in the state of Florida for being a full-time teacher. And they're going to be punished even further. They're the ones that are going to have to continue paying out of pocket because Ron DeSantis wants to make a political point to punish the teachers and punish the students because the school districts were smarter than Ron DeSantis was. Thanks for watching, and if you like what you saw, don't forget to like, comment, share, and most importantly, subscribe to our Ring of Fire channel here.